Next, we're talking with Walter Koenig, who, of course, everybody knows as Pavel Chekhov, Alfred Bester from Babylon 5. You've done so much more in Inalienable, as a writer, as a director, as a producer. By the way, happy birthday, and congratulations on your star on the Walk of Fame that happened this week.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you.
Now, what kind of an experience is that when you go out there and you pull that board up and there's your star? What's going through your mind in that event?
Well, you know, I've seen it done before. You know, I was present when George Takei had it, and Nichelle Nichols and DeForest Kelly and Jimmy Doohan. So it's not a new experience. It's only new in terms of the emotional content and how I'm reacting to it, that it's my star. I haven't really absorbed that yet, you know. I'm still working on why did I get it. And what if anything does it mean in the history of Hollywood and the history of the movie industry? Does it have any meaning? I don't know. I do a lot of it. That kind of introspection, trying to find the reason why I merit this award. And my shrink tells me just accept it and love it and let it go at that. So I'm trying to do that.
Now, you are working currently on a new web series, Star Trek Renegades, with Tim Russ. Is the web the new TV place? Is that where the new breakout hits are going to be, do you think? Because we're not seeing a whole lot of space shows on television right now. It's all, you know, dystopian stuff and fairy tales and whatnot. But out of all of the Star Trek cast, you seem to have embraced the web a little bit more with Phase 2 and Of Gods and Men, and now, you know, going back with Renegades. What's your take on where the web's going with that?
Well, I think it's going to be more and more significant. I think it's going to, you know, it's going to be a something that people will have to take into account once they find a way to make real money on it. You know, it's going to it'll probably be the most common way of showing movies and entertainment of all sorts. I don't know when, but I know that the studios, Warner's and Columbia and Disney, Universal, they're all into it, you know, CBS. They all feel that it's definitely part of our very near future.
In a hand-to-hand fight, who's going to win, Pavel Chekhov or Alfred Bester?
Well, Bester only has one hand. So we'll have to give it. We have to give it the Chekhov. He might have to do some flying kicks or something.
Now, being part of two different really influential franchises now, Babylon 5, Star Trek, has that been a double-edged sword for you as an actor, as a performer, that you're associated with these phenomenal series, these things that have had so much cultural impact? What's that done for your career, as opposed to maybe some opportunities that didn't come your way because you got typecast?
Well, I don't think it's a matter of typecasting. I mean, Bill Shatner played Captain Kirk, and he played it. You know, he was the lead in every episode for 3 years, and he did seven movies, and he was the lead. And people identify him with Captain Kirk, but they also identify him with the other series that he's done. I mean, he has had no problem getting work. I'm not sure why my career has been limited. I certainly don't think it's because that I have been known for these two characters. I think there are other things that more ephemeral, less easy to point to explain that.
Looking back, is there a type of character that you haven't played yet that you'd really like to sink your teeth into? You've been the good guy. You've been the space cadet, the really eager, you know, cadet. You've been the bad guy. What is there that you haven't done yet that you really want to do?
Well, I love comedy. And if they could come up with a good comedy, either TV, sitcom, or a feature, and give me an opportunity to exercise those chops, I would love doing that. I've done it a lot in the theater, and to good effect, to warm approval. So.
Well, and you had the stage bit with Mark Leonard for a long time, didn't you? Was that something you guys did? And that seemed to be very well received too. And a lot of people said that was hilarious.
Well, we did a couple together. We did Boys in Autumn, about Mark Twain, about Huckleberry Finn and Tom Sawyer meeting again after 40 years. And then we did a, of course, I can't think of it. I can't think of the name of it. It was a one-act play that was very funny. And we took on the road and we played in various venues. Can't think of the name of it.
Okay, what's next for you right now? What are you working on?
Well, I'm working on a graphic novel called Things to Come. It's about vampires after the apocalypse, but a different turn, a different twist on it. It's not about vampires in love, and it's not about vampires gouging each other's necks, you know, although that happens. But it's really about them. It's a very introspective piece, and it's about them trying to discover, learn who they are and why they're here, and what is their purpose in the greater realm of things. What purpose do they have? We're assuming that there is, you know, is there some kind of consciousness that has created these vampires? Is it just an evolution, you know, a natural evolution? And these are the kind of things that I deal with.
And that comes out when?
Well, I think it's going to come out October 20th. They needed a certain number of advance orders in order to publish. And in the last 4 days, with some big help from George Takei and other people passing around the information, the book, the graphic novel, reached number one and has been number one for 3 or 4 days. Among science fiction, fantasy kind of things. So that was certainly an indication that we might have enough for him to publish now.
And who's the publisher?
It's called Coldwater Productions.
Okay. All right, we'll be looking for it. Thank you very much, Walter Koenig. Good luck with the graphic novel. And remember, you can subscribe to our channel here on YouTube for the latest videos. For the latest science fiction news, go to scififorme.com.